Hi, I'm James Hamilton, and I'm here today to talk to you about our newest Graviton processor. Today, I'll announce the Amazon EC2 C7g instances. I'll also get into more detail on Graviton3, since the C7g is the first EC2 instance type built using the Graviton3 processor. Graviton is one of our four semiconductor product lines here at AWS. It's our general purpose CPU, delivering the best price performance of all instance types across all of EC2. We also have Trainium for machine learning training, Inferentia for machine learning inference, and Nitro, which is the foundation of our hardware accelerated hypervisor, allowing us to support network hardware offload, storage hardware offload, hypervisor offload, and security. When I joined AWS a bit more than 13 years ago, I would never have guessed we'd be designing and delivering custom processors, but scale supports innovation at every level. We're now a leading semiconductor design house. We do custom servers, custom storage racks, our own networking equipment, AWS optimized hypervisor and operating systems, and of course, the AWS service stacks above. I'm particularly proud of the innovations we've made in silicon over the years. We launched the first generation Graviton CPU back in 2018, and it delivered significant cost savings for scale-out workloads. Only 1 year later, we followed up with Graviton 2, which gave up to 40% better price performance than comparable x86 processors. And today, 2 years later, we're announcing Graviton 3 powered C7G instances. We deliver even higher performance for compute intensive workloads. Let's look at some of the details. Today we announced the general availability of C7G. These are the first EC2 instances powered by the latest generation Graviton 3. C7G provides up to 25% better performance than the predecessor C6G, which already offered 40% better price performance than comparable x86 processors. It's only been 2 years since we launched Graviton 2, and I believe the 25% generational performance gain we're delivering in Graviton 3 is going to be a big step forward for customers. The AWS Annapurna team is behind all four of our semiconductor product lines, and they continue to take on aggressive goals, work through the challenges that inevitably come up during large engineering projects, and yet they still reliably hit schedules, consistently over-deliver on performance. Graviton 3 is a big step forward. Comparing Graviton 3 to our previous generation processor, we see up to 2x better floating point performance, 2x faster crypto performance, and 3x faster machine learning performance. It's based on the ARM Neoverse V1 core, where each core has a private 64K L1 cache, as well as a private L2 at 1 meg. Our partnership with ARM continues to produce very good results for our customers. Graviton 3 is the first server in the AWS fleet to support DDR5 memory, and it delivers 50% more bandwidth than the previous generation DDR4. Throughout the Graviton program, you may have noticed we always focus on the importance of memory bandwidth to real-world application performance, and with Graviton 3, we continue that focus by offering 8 lanes of DDR5 per socket. Each Graviton 3 package has 55 billion transistors and is made up of 7 chiplets, one main compute die in the center, 4 DRAM controller dies on the edge, and 2 PCIe dies. We elected to implement Graviton 3 as a multi-chip module to reduce costs and to increase yields as the size and complexity of modern server processors continues to grow. This improves manufacturing economics, but it also allows future Gravitons to be fabricated using a leading process node, while at the same time, some of the less rapidly evolving I/O components, for example, the PCIe die, can remain unchanged. Unlike some contemporary server CPUs, the Graviton 3 compute die is monolithic. All 64 cores are on that single die. This allows us to deliver 64 cores with uniform memory access latencies rather than exposing to application developers the complexity of managing different local and remote memory accesses. Graviton 3 memory is uniform over all cores and over all memory. Looking logically above the Graviton to the actual board design of the C7G instance, each Graviton 3 motherboard supports 3 servers. You'll see all 3 servers are supported by a single Nitro processor, further improving overall cost and efficiency. We exploit that power efficiency of the Graviton 3 to cost effectively deploy 3 servers per rack unit. That's about 1.75 inches, without requiring exotic or expensive cooling solutions. This reduces costs, but the energy efficiency of Graviton3 also helps customers reduce their carbon footprints. Graviton3 instances are up to 60% less energy for the same performance as a comparable EC2 instance. Graviton3 has the performance needed for modern compute-intensive applications, such as gaming, video encoding, machine learning, high-performance computing, while at the same time delivering the power performance and price performance customers seek for less demanding general-purpose workloads. We announced a preview of C7g at the AWS reInvent conference last year, and hundreds of customers have since benchmarked their workloads. Let's look at some of those examples. Twitter ran a number of benchmarks representative of their workloads and found that C7g delivered up to 80% better performance than the previous generation, C6g. In addition, they reported a reduction in tail latency of as much as 35%. Formula One ran their computational fluid dynamics workloads on C7g and found them to deliver 40% better performance than C6g. Honeycomb.io, an early adopter of Graviton, saw a 35% performance improvement and a 30% reduction in latency compared to the previous generation C6G for their telemetry ingestion workload. It's exciting to see such great results from our customers, and I'm looking forward to seeing more data points like these now that C7G has become generally available. The Graviton portfolio now consists of 13 instance families across 23 AWS regions around the globe. The various Graviton instance families offer different memory, CPU, storage, networking resource mixes to support a wide variety of workloads, including general purpose, burstable, compute intensive, memory intensive, storage intensive, and accelerated computing. Each family is optimized for a class of common workload or a workload characteristic. Customers are running a wide variety of applications of the Graviton family, including app servers, microservices, high performance computing, non-accelerated ML inference, video encoding, electronic design automation, accelerated graphics, gaming, open source databases, and in-memory caching. One thing to keep in mind when you're thinking about this is many AWS managed services already support Graviton, including Aurora, RDS, ElastiCache, EMR, Lambda, and Fargate. These services offer all the benefits of Graviton with little or no additional development effort on the behalf of customers. In addition to these managed services from AWS, a wide variety of partner solutions are validated, optimized, and supported for Graviton in the AWS Graviton Ready program. The number of applications supported on Graviton continues to grow quickly, and we expect the general availability of Graviton 3 we're announcing today will accelerate that trend. In closing, I hope some of the data points I've covered today convince you that you really need to try your most important workloads on Graviton 3 using the EC2 C7G instances that we announced today. I'm convinced you'll see material gains. For those of you less certain or wanting to have a look without spending, we continue to have a free trial available for Graviton 2 using the EC2 T4G instances. Thousands of customers across all sizes of NGOs and industries are already running production workloads on Graviton. Graviton 3 is another big step forward, and we're excited now that it's generally available today. These are the first instances powered by AWS Graviton 3, and there's more to come later this year. I can't wait to see what you build in the newest member of the Graviton family. Thanks very much for your support, and thanks for watching.